have, if you think about essay structure, you might want to have to put that in order. If you have a color code, you could start out with it blank and then show them colors. So it's a good way to involve kinesthetic learners as well as graphic students. There are lots of these pre-made flip charts actually, and if you go up to insert page, you're able to get flip chart to look like this. This one's an alphabet flip chart, so you might have to drag a copy, for instance, to create words. And you have it on drag a copy, and that means that every time you drag, it won't keep it out of here, it'll make a copy. So for instance, this is Kitchen with you. Another one, WordBank, which is similar. So it's great for your kids, especially I think like kindergarten, first grade, they really need to move around because maybe you've seen students who are fidgeting, and that's because you just want to be rest time. And so having students get up to the active board, really interact with it, is a great way to learn about the topic. Life cycle of a frog. I am not really a big science buff, but I saw these flip charts. I believe it was used by Zachy. And so you can have students sort them out, and you might have a poll afterwards if it's correct, if it's incorrect, and have other students have to practice if it's not. So you can see. Over here. And it's funny, I had no idea that they had this long tail. And then finally, you can have also, again, for your students, you have different types of coinage. Dragging the text onto the reference, so Kenny.